Hello, I'm Sahana Murthy from IIT Bombay and welcome to this course on Educational Technology for Engineering Teachers. This is a MOOC aimed at college instructors from engineering and science institutions. And what we will do in the next few minutes is discuss about what the course is about, what are the contents in it, what's the format, what the teachers will be expected to do, what kind of infrastructure and resources we will provide, and so on. So the goal, the reason we are running this course comes, from a number of teaching and learning issues that our college instructors face in their classrooms. Faculty members face problems like varying student interest and abilities. And most of us as teachers have tried several strategies to mitigate these problems and to address these problems. But we still face problems such as students focusing too much on exam testing, managing large classes, and so on. So it turns out that there are several educational research-based strategies and techniques that can help address these problems. So what I mean by research-based is that there's data that show that some of these techniques directly help in improving either student learning or student engagement in these classes. In addition, technology can play a very key role in helping us improve our teaching and hence improve student learning. So in this course, what we will do is focus on the integration of ICT, information and communication technologies, with student-centric learning, active learning strategies in order to improve the entire teaching learning experience. So this is the broad overall goal of the course. So this course will provide an introduction to these research-based and learner-centric pedagogical strategies. What teachers will do in this course is first get familiar with some of these strategies. We will also take some example technologies and walk through how to integrate these technologies with the strategies. And then the participants of this course will apply this knowledge into topics that they are teaching in their own classes. And they will design materials, design assignments and questions. They will design lesson plans using technology and come up with tangible resources that they can actually go and use in their own classes. So the way we've designed this course is that once you learn something in, say, 1 week, you should go and try it out in your class the same week or the next week. For this, we have discussion forums where you can actually come and discuss what you did in your class, share your experiences with us, and so on.
So one reason for why we are doing this course is that often we focus on ourselves as teachers and keep improving our teaching learning process and keep improving the way we deliver lectures. Often it happens that however good lecturers we may be, the amount of learning that happens at the student end is controlled by the amount of practice or the amount of work that the students are able to do. So one of the key things that we are doing through this course is trying to move to a student-centric mechanism of teaching learning, whereby there will be many activities which you can have your students do in the class. So what you will be doing as part of this course is not only you will be experiencing these activities, you will also be designing activities for carrying out in your own classes. So the key idea here is something that we call as constructive alignment. So often as teachers, we explain things in the classroom. We expect students to solve problems, you know, do homeworks and so on. And then we give exams. So sometimes we are disappointed that students don't perform up to our expectations. So one reason for this is that the alignment between what our learning objective was, the instructional strategy that we use in the class, and the assessment questions that we use in the exam is not perfect. So when we align these three properly, namely the learning objectives, the instructional strategies, and the assessment questions, that is when we find that there is maximum student gain in terms of learning. So as part of this course, one of the things that we will be doing is to focus more and more on doing this alignment for each of you in each of your courses. And this we will do through the mechanism of being pertinent to your own course. So that is again a very important idea that we are introducing here. So instead of simply us talking about hypothetical courses and how to teach, what we will be doing as part of the assignments and various exercises is taking topics from your own course, which you will be teaching in the next semester, and guiding you through to getting alignment between these instructional objectives, the instructional strategies, and the assessment part.
Okay, so having discussed why constructive alignment is important and what is important, let's now look at the formal structure of the course briefly. So we will start with learning objectives because they do form the backbone of every teaching and learning initiative. We will discuss what they are, why they are important, and most importantly, you will write learning objectives for your own course. And you will write them in a manner that the expectations from the students also become clear. We will then spend a couple of weeks on specific active learning strategies. Now, active learning is not simply asking a student, what do you think, or do you have any doubts? That's not active learning. And that has, while that's useful and important, that doesn't have any data, much data to show that student learning improves simply because we ask students, what are your doubts? So active learning strategies have been derived from some learning theories, and they have been tested in the sense that if they are implemented in a certain manner, then student learning and student engagement improves. Which means that as teachers, we need to learn what these strategies are and how we should implement them in class. So we will go over that for a couple of weeks, and then we will spend the rest of the time in this MOOC picking one or two technologies that are relevant for you. For example, as engineering instructors, you may be using visualizations a lot in class, simulations and animations to depict a concept. And we will discuss issues like how should you select a good visualization for your own topic? How should you teach with them once you've selected them? What should the students do? And it turns out that the students should not simply watch them, they should do something much more with them. So these are issues that we will discuss in the rest of the MOOC. We will also spend a week talking about assessment strategies because it comes back to this issue of alignment between the objectives, the strategies, and the assignment. And we will see how to write assessment questions where you can actually test students' knowledge and application on a lot of higher order cognitive levels. So in terms of how the course format, how this course is structured, how this MOOC is structured, every week you will, when you log in to your to the IITBX platform, you will see what are called learning dialogue videos, so or LED videos, you know, LED light bulbs. So these learning dialogue videos have some information and there is some knowledge about the topic, and then they contain thought-provoking questions inside the video that are called reflection spots. So what you need to do at these reflection spots is think about the question that has been posed, write your response, or maybe think about the response, pause the video at that point, and then once you have figured out what is your understanding or what's your response to that reflection question, then you move on. So there are a few learning dialogue videos in each week, and as we all know, it's not simply enough to think and listen, we have to really practice. So there are several learning by doing or LBD activities that are based on the knowledge in these LED videos. Some of these are short self-assessment quizzes, some may be longer where you have to create an assignment for your class or write learning objectives and so on. And without doing the LBD activities, really it's not much point simply listening. So we really encourage all of you to go through and do the LBD activities every week. And to extend your knowledge, we also have a set of resources called Learning Extension Resources or LXT Resources. So these contain, among other items, voices from the field, which are instructors just like you who've tried and who've been using these strategies and these technologies for the past few years, and they'll share with us their experiences, what worked, how it worked, the challenges they faced and how they address these challenges. So those are really important because these are exactly colleagues, some of them may be in your colleges, who've been using this and they'll share their experiences with us.
Yeah, so to emphasize, what we will be expecting is a lot of work. So since this is a practice-based course, so we will be providing a lot of immersion in the type of activities that we expect you to carry out in your class by carrying out those activities ourselves. And then we would be expecting that you will design such activities for your own students. So there is a lot of practice involved in this course. It's not a course in which we can simply listen to the videos, answer the quizzes and get a grade. So as a result of that, it is, even though this is a online course, it is desirable if a large number of teachers from each college do this course together so that they can talk to each other about the contents of the course. And there is also a component of peer assessment. So we would, while we will be providing peer assessment mechanism through the IITBX platform, we would also encourage that you discuss with each other your activities, thereby refining the activity. So we will be providing rubrics on the basis of which you can grade yourself about how well the activities that you have designed are, how well aligned they are the activities aligned with the learning objectives and so on. What would be also good is if you have colleagues in your own college with whom you can discuss these activities, because that will improve your practice for the next semester.
Okay, so now let's come to how you will get the certificates in this course. So since this is a MOOC on the IITBX platform, we have something called an honor code certificate, and there'll be several assignments and activities, both short, medium and long, every week. And you'll be expected to spend about 6 to 7 hours a week on going through the videos, doing the activities, doing the assignments and so on. So for grading, we have knowledge quizzes, we will have resource creation assignments where you will actually create these assignments and questions for your own class, and we'll also have some reflection quizzes. So all these will be provided, the details are provided in the course handout. In addition, there will be assignments where you will create something for your class, and as we just discussed, you will provide feedback to your peers, your colleagues' work, and your colleagues will provide feedback on your work. So these are peer feedback assignments that we will have a few of them in the course. And these are really valuable because it's really our colleagues who can give us the best feedback on whether something is likely to work and how to improve it. And finally, our long-term goal is to collect all these activities and assignments that you've created and create a huge repository of them for all of us to use in our classes in the next few. You know, next semesters and next years and so on. In addition, if you want the, if you are interested in the IST certification, then there are some criteria that you have to meet. You have to upload some evidence that you are a teacher, you are teaching in a college at this point, and there will be a few additional assignments, and as the course goes on, we will we'll give you details about the additional assignments. So let's stop here. Yeah.
So to summarize, even though there is a lot of work in the course, we hope that this will be very useful to you, primarily because this is targeted specifically for your own course, which you will be able to use for your own students in the next semester or the following semesters. And hopefully your students will derive a lot of benefit through the active learning strategies that you now, activities that you design and the strategies that you implement in your classroom. Thank you.
Okay, so at this point, we can take a few questions. So if you have any questions about the course content and format, you can do a hand raise and we'll try to address some of your questions. Okay, Center 1263, Salt Lake, Kolkata. Please go ahead.
Madam, it was not clear about the certificate portion. Could you please go through it once again, the certification part, the last part of it?
Okay, so the question is, what are the details of the certification? So I'll just quickly summarize what I said a few minutes ago. If there will be several assignments every week, and the details will be provided once you log into that week's module. you do the assignments, and the course handout and every week's module will say, will tell you, you know, how much there, you know, how many points there are, and so on. So you will get an honor code certificate if you do a certain number of assignments. In addition, there'll be extra assignments, and if you do the extra assignments, you can get an IST certification if you are a current teacher in a college.
Hello. Okay. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
Next question.
One more question.
Mukesh Patel School of Technology. Go ahead, please.
Good morning to you all, and best wishes for a happy new year. Just want to ask a few questions. First of all, I should really thank IIT Bombay for taking this initiative, because this is an initiative which is what we were also thinking, and we had troubled IIT Bombay, some of the resource persons. Just want to know what would be the engagement from the faculty, say, in a week, and how will the timing be, because we are just starting our semester next week. We are very keen to enroll our faculty in this program. How would the engagement be, what timings of the week or how many hours a week, and how do we see that our faculty really gets engaged in this with a set timetable or some pre-announced timings for the entire week, a week before. And we would also like the faculty to be assessed on this, because this is a very welcome initiative in which we also want to move towards. If we can define some course outcomes, then course objectives, it would be very good, and that will help us in assessing the faculty also.
Okay.
In fact, in our performance management system for the faculty, we do have a component of this, which we would like to use the assessment very clearly for.
Okay, so let me answer the two questions one by one. So how much time is expected to be devoted by your faculty members? So approximately each week's material is worth about 5 hours of effort in that week. So, and there is a lot of flexibility on when your faculty member is able to do those 5 hours. So there is no strict timetable, since this is an online course.
Course material.
All the course material will be uploaded, as is the usual practice of IIT Bombay X, on
Thursdays.
So the faculty can, some faculty might want to just do the whole thing over the weekend and then, you know, not look at it till the next Thursday. Others may want to spend 1 hour a day looking at the videos, maybe another time doing the assignments, and so on and so forth. So that entire flexibility is in your faculty's hands of when they do the course. What is expected is that in order to reasonably go through 1 week's material, they have to do about 5 hours of work.
I'll just add one small thing with this. We will release the course materials, the LED videos, LBD activities, and assignments every Thursday for that module. For the assignments, the participants will get 10 days to submit it. So the assignments are due end of Sunday the following week. Okay, in terms of learning outcomes, there we do have learning objectives and learning outcomes for this course from the participants. And some of these are related to the knowledge gain, some are about the application. So for example, at the knowledge level, one of the first learning objectives is that participants should be able to describe the core components of effective teaching and learning designs in their own course. At the application level, participants should be able to create assignments which adhere to the constructive alignment principles. But we also have larger objectives related to building community. So for example, we want participants to contribute to a repository of resources. All these objectives are in the course handout, and they will be put up as soon as the course starts. So all the details are in the course handout.
Yeah, and coming to the part of how will you assess whether your faculty have learned enough from the course or not? So as part of the assignments that are being done by them in the MOOC, the scores of those assignments will be there, the rubric scores for your faculty, and these can be accessed by your faculty, since that will be open, and you can ask them to share their scores with you for you to know how well they have performed in the course.
Next question. Yeah, center 1261, please.
Hello.
Please go ahead.
Good morning. I'm from MIT in
we had recently conducted a course on technical communication for teachers, and around 40 plus participants from our end participated in this workshop, which was successfully completed in December. Can you please tell me in what way this course is different than technical communication workshop?
Okay.
Will there be any repetition of some of the contents?
Yeah. So the question is, in what way is this course different from a technical communication course that was recently conducted? So my first answer is, this course is very complementary to the technical communication course, but in terms of content, there isn't much overlap, because the core focus of this particular course is on teaching practices and teaching strategies, especially with the use of technology. So we are not focusing on broad communication issues. On the other hand, we are looking at specific topics that you will be teaching in your own course, and looking at what strategies that you can use. What I mean by a strategy is that what is it that the teacher needs to do, what the students should be doing at that point, how the teacher can help the manage, or how the teacher can ensure that the students do what they're supposed to do. It's an orchestrated activity. Some are short, could be as short as 2 minutes, some may be 15 or 20 minutes long. So we will go over a few such strategies. And the other core focus of this course is that you will be creating materials for your own courses. So it's not about more broad communication issues, which are also important and which were covered in the previous course. But here we'll look at examples, and we'll look at application to your own course on teaching learning strategies.
Okay. Let me also add that some of your teachers may have done similar modules in workshops that we have conducted earlier as part of T10KT. So they may have attended these workshops. However, the key difference is that now, since it is a MOOC, the contents are available for them to look at their own pace. So in the workshop, they may have had to stick to our schedules, and no, they may not have been able to give adequate attention to the various assignments when we had put it up. Whereas now, because they have the entire week to do it at their own pace, it would be very useful for them. So even if your teachers have already taken our previous workshop, which was last year around February, even then, it would be good to encourage them to take this MOOC, because this will give them the content in a form which they can refer to periodically, as well as it will give them time to create their assignments, get it graded at a more comfortable pace.
Center 1061, please.
Good morning,
go ahead.
Sir and Good morning. Madam. So, Happy New Year. So, whether all the discipline faculty can be registered, or in this any limitation is there?
So, the idea is that this is targeted.
Whether all the faculty.
Yes.
Whether all the discipline faculty members can be registered, or any limitation is there?
Yes, the question is whether faculty from all disciplines can register, and the course is actually targeted towards engineering and science faculty. So most engineering disciplines faculty will be able to relate to the examples that are being given, and the assignments also will be targeted towards faculty who are teaching undergraduate engineering courses and also science courses. Center 1207.
Hello, good morning, sir.
Yeah, go ahead, please.
Good morning, sir.
Go ahead, please.
Sir, am I audible?
Yes, sir, please go ahead. Sir? Yes, please go ahead.
Sir, my question is that, yes. Actually, the assignment, sometimes the assignment is not available in a mobile. many times we are facing the problem that we not found the some specimen copy of what should be how we can give the assignment and how we can prepare the assignment. Sometimes questions are very tough, so we are some forum is there, but we not found the answer of that particular questions. As I felt in that pedagogy workshop, our participants was very confused regarding assignment.
Okay, so we are not really using Moodle this time. We are using the IIT Bombay X platform, where many of these questions are now going to be taken care of. It will be easy to find the assignments. There will also be some, you know, and since we are doing this over 4 weeks, many of the assignments will be somewhat shorter than the assignments that you had encountered in the previous Education Technology for Engineering Teachers workshop. Also, there will be discussion forums where you can interact with other teachers about what they are doing. There will also be TAs who will be available during the discussion forum. There will be office hours which we will be maintaining online. So, on fixed days for fixed duration, we will also be available for online clarification of queries. So the key idea here is, since you don't have to do the assignment within one day, you have about 10 days to complete the assignment and upload it, you will be able to discuss with others and, you know, get clarifications before you have to do the assignment.
Okay, sir, thank you, sir.
Center 1206.
So what is the total duration of the course? How long it will take? And second question is whether the some reading material will be available.
Yeah. So the first module of the first module will be released on Thursday, Jan 7th, and the course will run for 6 weeks. And every Thursday, the next week's module will be released. And there will be reading material, there will be videos that you can watch, there will be links to external reading material which will be posted each week. Before that, the course handout will be available in the beginning of next week.
It is there.
Yeah, the course handout.
Course handout and course calendar is available in
the... If you log into the IITBX course, which you should already be seeing, the course handout and the calendar has already been posted. Center 1147.
Hello. Hello. I'm Krishna Swami, Dean, Kongu Engineering College, Erode. I am interested in knowing, when you are conducting for all engineering courses, there are about 600 subjects in engineering courses. How are you going to develop the course for a particular subject?
Okay. That's a good question. And the key thing is that we are not doing discipline specific or topic specific training. It's also possible to do it in that manner. However, the way we are doing it is, what we will expect your teachers to do is come with their own course material. And our job is to help them convert that course material into a more student-centric form, whereby they can do active learning in the classroom and ensure that the learning of the student is better than simply transmitting the information. So while the point is well taken, because we are not experts on all these various disciplines, but the objective is that we will find other teachers of the same discipline who will be doing the peer assessment and the peer feedback of the assignments that are submitted by your teachers.
Yeah, having said that, there are some characteristics that may be common across different across engineering subjects. For example, in many engineering subjects, there is some principle or some equation or some principle that the student has to learn, where there are variables that need to be manipulated, that when something increases, something else decreases. So we are going to look at simulations which are very effective in helping students learn such principles. Some of the examples, we will give examples in our own videos and in our own resources. We will try to keep them to extremely introductory level topics, again, which not everybody will be familiar with, but we hope a large number of people will be familiar with.
then it's better from one discipline. That means if mechanical engineering and mechanical engineering oriented faculty joined together for one time course, and then computer and other circuit branches join second time, will it be better?
Perhaps yes, but it's a question of bandwidth at our end. You know, we have to then do 10 courses for 10 different disciplines. So we are currently focusing on the broad, you know, the examples will be mostly from CS and, you know, EE disciplines at this point. So you must definitely encourage your teachers from CS and electrical and electronics and communication disciplines to attend.
I could understand.
Yeah.
Is it possible to cover the general things in 1 or 2 days in continuous WhatsApp and then leave the things like assignments and all for a longer time for them to develop themselves?
So, see, each week there will be some initial part which is general for everybody, and the assignments which will be specific for that person's course which the person intends to teach for the next semester. So the pacing is totally up to the learner at this point. So in this case, the learners are your student, are teachers at your college. So they can pace it out over 1 week the way they find it convenient.
And since even though we've repeated this, I think it's important for everyone. That's why I'm saying it again. If you can find a group of teachers from a particular discipline in your college to attend, and the group can be something like 3 or 5, then they will benefit a lot more because they have the domain knowledge and they can discuss the exam, the application of our, the principles that we discuss into their domain.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Center 1145.
Good morning and happy welcome to all viewers. This is from KMU Engineering College. First of all, let me wish a happy new year to all viewers. My question about course materials is already been answered. Thank you for that. And I have one more suggestion regarding that after conductor course, you will be getting feedback. And we would like to get the feedback from you so that for the next program, we'll be able to do some modifications and we can accept your suggestions to improve. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you for your suggestion. Center 1152. We are not hearing your audio, 1152. Please check your mic. Still no audio. Please resolve your audio issues, we will come back to you.
Hello?
Yeah, 1008, please go ahead.
Hello? Happy New Year, sir, madam. I am from 1008. We have participated in all courses conducted under e-outreach. My one question is that there are some good case studies as far as active learning is concerned at our institute. Mm-hmm. Is there any scope to add our case study and in this course, it will be presented all over India to all the faculties and CS.
Okay, so to begin with, I think what we can do is when we discuss the module on active learning, we will open the discussion forum. So the first thing you can do is present your case study there in the discussion forum, because one of the questions in the discussion forums will be share your experiences, especially if you have implemented it, and tell us what worked and what didn't. So let's start from there, and then we will see if we want to, you know, how what else we can do with it.
So there are two more things that we can do. So one is if your teachers have written some papers about how they did the active learning, what was the gains that they got out of it, they can put up the paper at some site, and they can provide a link to that paper in the discussion forum. So we will be monitoring the discussion forum, and we will collect these papers together to make it available to everyone. The second thing they can do is if they also have videos that they have created, they can put it up somewhere on YouTube and once again put up the link in the discussion forum. Once again, what we will do is we will collect these and we will perhaps what we will do is we'll use them as voices from the field for the next offering of this course.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Okay. Thank you.
Center 1012.
Hello. Hello, good morning.
Yes, please go ahead.
Yeah, good morning. Are you able to hear me?
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you and happy new year to you. My question is, how many maximum faculty can register from each center?
As many as you want. There's no restriction in this course.
For these courses.
So there is no restriction in the course.
No restriction.
You can have all your faculty registered.
Like you said that. Okay.
As many as you want, and everybody who has completed the and everybody who completes the required assignments will get the certificate.
What? Next question. Okay. Thank you. And then another question is that examples, like you said that EE and some related examples, you will be taking more. So can you include this examples from civil engineering, mechanical engineering discipline also, because we have this discipline also at our institute. So is there any possibility?
So at this point, what we can do is we can do this as part of the discussion forum only. Because the examples that for which we have created the videos and we have created the assignments, those are examples on which we have expertise. So we don't have any civil engineering faculty as part of the course faculty of this course. So we don't want to make claims about domains that we don't understand fully ourselves. But those examples can be done as part of the discussion forum, where we can create a group of, a separate forum for people who are registered from civil engineering, separate forum for people who are registered from mechanical engineering. And those discussions can be moderated.
Thank you. So
1300, please go ahead. No audio, please check your mic.
Okay. Hello?
Yeah, hello, please go ahead.
Am I on?
Hello,
please go ahead.
No, we can't hear you.
Hello?
Yeah.
Hello?
Perhaps if you hold the mic closer.
Closer.
Closer, okay. Now, am I audible now?
Yeah,
yes,
better.
Please go ahead.
Hello? Yeah. So, good morning, everyone, and a very happy new year to both of you as well as all the participants. So, this is for the first time that I'm being associated with the outreach program, because I took over as the chairperson only last week. So, I feel that this program, this outreach program is going to be very useful for our faculty, because we are going to apply for the MBA accreditation. Most of my questions have been answered. But what I want to know is that since it is not a college, it's a university department, therefore we are running the postgraduate courses. So how useful would this program be for the teachers of sciences? Because we are having MTech program as well as MSc program. We don't have the undergraduate programs in our department. So how useful would this course be for the postgraduate?
So, yeah. Okay. Yeah, so the question is, how useful would this course be for postgraduate teachers? And the course will be useful, because it will be as useful, because the active learning strategies or the integration of technology techniques that we will discuss, they are not really tied to whether you're teaching a UG course or a PG course or even a school level course. And these come from fundamental learning theories and technology integration principles and so on. Where the difference may happen is in the application of it. So if you have a group of teachers who are teaching a particular postgraduate course, they can apply the same ideas, same principles that we discuss in the MOOC into their subjects.
Good morning, sir, madam. I am Smita Desai, RCC, Remote Center Coordinator. Madam, I would like to ask you that what is the role of RC Center and how RCC can contribute for this workshop.
Okay, so looks like there is some mobile ringing at your end. Yeah. So, okay, so we got the question, how, what is the role of the remote center and how the remote center can contribute. So, one way of contribution is to have, you know, weekly meetings of the teachers who have registered for the course at your center. And, you know, they can do the discussions face to face rather than do the discussions through the online forum. And now if you can also ensure that, you know, teachers from one particular discipline are discussing within that discipline, it will be more effective. So we will also towards the end have a few live interaction sessions once the MOOC part of it is over, and then we are moving into the ISTE part of it. So, but primarily the contribution will be in terms of making sure that the teachers who have registered at your college are having adequate peer support in order to do the assignments so that they can use them for their next semester's courses.
One Very good morning seven to you. Please go ahead. Yeah.
Shall I start?
Yes, please.
Very good morning to you. We thank IIT for providing us opportunity to our teachers for this initiative. My question is, sir, the simulations and the assignments which you are going to give it to us, will they be content specific or they'll be context based, generalized type of things?
Okay, so the simulations will be at a level where, you know, in order to understand what, how to do the teaching learning with the simulation, the content will be fairly generic so that all the teachers can follow. But subsequent to getting immersed in the content or getting immersed in the teaching learning practice, what we will have is an assignment for your teachers to go and find content which is useful for them for their next semester's course. And then they will be designing activities of what they will have their own students to do in their classroom using that content. So that content will be specific to the domain.
Yeah. So you don't have to be worried that a teacher doesn't know a particular domain, so how will they do the assignment? So you don't need to be concerned about that, because the domain comes only when the teacher has to create questions and activities for their own classes.
So you will be dealing specifically with the pedagogy part of it?
Yes.
Thank you.
Center 1310.
Hello.
Hello.
Am I audible?
Yes, please go ahead.
Yeah. Our student who will participate in the IITX Bombay portal, either in UA?
No, this particular course is for college instructors, but we can, if you have PhD students or MTech students who are intending to be faculty members sometime in the future, the course would be useful for them.
Okay, madam, I have another question. Madam, the assignment type is subjective type or any quiz type?
What Both.
Is the type of assignment?
Both.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
1080.
Center 1080. Hello, madam. Actually, some of our faculty, they have attended a pedagogy course. Mm-hmm. So for them, it will be the same content or it will be having any new topics, etc. That is one question. Another question is, weekly there will be some assignment and deadlines. What if it will be extended to next week, or what is actually the plan, madam?
Okay. So for the people who have already undergone the pedagogy course, like I said a little time ago, this MOOC will actually not only be a refresher, it will also help them to enhance their knowledge, because the pedagogy course was fairly compressed and the timelines were much stricter. So whereas here they have almost 10 days to complete one assignment and they have 1 week to view the contents and, you know, do the activities associated with each week's material. Also they can look at all these videos later, which was not available for them in the pedagogy course. So even if your teachers have already attended the pedagogy course, it is really important for them to attend the MOOC, because it will not only reinforce, but it will also extend. So there will be some overlap, which is good for them, because all the material will not be entirely new to them. At the same time, there will be a lot of extension. So this course is designed completely from the perspective of them being able to use the material that they generate, and them being confident that they can use this material in their courses. So I hope that answers both your questions.
Yes, sir. I have one more question, actually. So this course is very good for teachers, but actually some of our students are demotivated in engineering these things. So do we have any new method so that we can motivate them, and because they joined somehow in engineering stream and later they don't find interest to complete find interest to attend all the classes. So that type of thing is going on in many private engineering college. That is the major problem. So this course in any way going to address such issues?
So the course as such is, the scope of the course is teaching learning strategies. Okay, now the extent to which you can excite students about the topic, that depends upon the teacher. And what the teacher does in the class is that the teacher can design activities which will keep the students engaged. Then the teacher can, we will also talk about mechanisms by which you can make the course very relevant. For example, one of the ways in which we are making this course relevant is by taking topics that your teachers are going to teach in the next semester. Similarly, it's up to the teacher to make their courses relevant to the students by giving examples from real life context, by giving assignments and activities which are meaningful to the students. So that is one way in which indirectly you can engage the students back into the content of the course.
So one more strategy that we will be discussing, which actually people have used and have shown improvement in engagement if done properly, are what we earlier referred to as the active learning strategies. Now the thing is, the main goal there is that instead of lecturing straight on for 60 minutes, the teacher breaks up the class and maybe gives some information for the first 10 minutes and then does a 10 or 15 minute activity where there is learning happening, but it's the students who are putting together the learning, they're discussing with each other, they are answering some questions and so on. So it's not a waste of time, those 15 minutes. If anything, it's where the students themselves are highly engaged into the material, into the content. So we will discuss two or three such strategies which you can do in your class.
Thank you.
Center 1263.
Hello. Good morning and happy new year to all of you. One question from Techno India Solde, that is, the faculty members will participate. You told that is on Thursday if you are going to put the upload the assignments and all, how much time the faculties will get to complete that assignment?
For assignments,
that is one question.
They have,
another question is, hello?
Yeah, for assignments, they have 10 days to submit the assignments.
How much?
10 days.
Hello? 10 days time. Okay, that is enough. And one more question is, the all the faculties from each and every engineering department can participate in this activity? Or is there any specific engineering topic is there?
No, all the engineering faculty can participate. All of them can participate.
All the engineering, all
yes.
From all the streams.
Yes.
From all the streams.
All, everybody is eligible to participate, but you may find that some disciplines are represented more in our examples and videos. So computer science and electrical engineering will have, our examples will have, will be mostly from these two disciplines, but everybody is eligible to participate.
Okay. Ma'am, one more question. You talked about something about AICT, because this program will definitely helpful for the self-improvement of the faculty, that is 100%. But what extra weightage they will get from AICT, is there anything else?
So that is a question which we will have to leave to Professor Fatak, because who is not here at this point. So he will be sending out email with details of, you know, how the AICT thing works.
Then in that case, we can involve more and more faculty in that, if that information we'll get. Okay, thank you very much.
1034.
Hello.
Yes, please go ahead. We can hear you.
Hello. This is Dr. Vikas Inamdar from MES IMCC Pune. My question is whether there is any further segregation or grading pattern in your honor code certificates.
No, there is no segregation. So we will put up the requirements for honor code, eligibility for honor code in the course handout itself, and there is no further categories in that. Yeah, so the course handout has already been shared with all the principals.
Yeah, but 50% and above you get honor code certificate. My point is there should be scope for excellence. Those who perform in a better way, say if somebody gets 70% or 80%, so there should be some distinction or segregation between the performance of the faculty members.
So
we have got different percentages.
So right now, from our end, what we can only do as part of the IIT Bombay X is to do this honor code certification. But however, the certification also mentions the percentage. So what you could do at your end is to do the, you know, recognition for faculty who have scored above 80% and all. That could be done at your end. But as far as the certificate is concerned, you know, the entire edX platform itself has only this one mechanism of honor code certificate.
Yeah. And again, the reason why it's so is there in the name. It's an honor code certificate. So the goal of this course is really not to certify that this teacher is excellent and that teacher is just medium, but it is for teachers to learn and improve their own teaching practice and learning and so on. The reason we have the assignments is so that they can practice, and that's the way new knowledge is assimilated. Hence, it's only an honor code certificate.
But what is the exact meaning of the honor code certificate?
Okay, the honor code means that we trust the person who is saying that I have done the assignment. We trust that person has done the assignment on their own and they have not had help from anybody else, and they have done the entire assignment on their own. Because there is no mechanism for us to verify whether the person who has uploaded the assignment is indeed the person who has done the assignment. So that is the meaning of honor code. We leave it to the honor of the participant.
Next question.
Is it the bottom line or the benchmark?
I don't know what that means.
Anyway, For this course, we have a 50%. If participants do 50% in the assignments, they will get a certificate. That's the policy of this course.
Okay.
Center 1131.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, madam. There is one suggestion from my side. We receive a material which is in form of handouts, videos, research papers, and so on. But many of the teachers of engineering and technology are new to the basic concepts of educational technology. So if you recommend or if you make available some e-copy of a basic book like textbook on educational technology, our faculty will be familiar with all the basic terms and terminology in educational technology. So this is my suggestion. One more question is there from our principal. Good morning, sir. Normally, there is a course coordinator for every course. This course is an online course, therefore there is no course coordinator. Therefore, probably it will be difficult for the institution to monitor whether their participants are performing or not. Do you have any system to know this?
So, it will be difficult to monitor the performance of the cohort from
their side.
That's up to them.
Okay. Yeah. So, for the first part of the question, there is no prerequisite required for this course. Okay, so it is not necessary that your teachers have already read a book on education technology, because the course itself provides the required training for them to be able to use education technology. So instead of the textbook, what we are going to provide are the videos on a weekly basis and the assignments on a weekly basis. So if the teacher is going through that, that would be sufficient for them. And for the second question about there not being a coordinator at your end. So yes, the course does not require a coordinator at your end. However, if you do have a coordinator at your end and you do create a you know, timetable of, you know, weekly meeting of people who are registered for this course, it will benefit those teachers immensely. But that is, right now we are leaving that as a voluntary activity from the centers themselves. Because since this is an online course, we cannot make it available for everyone. So the individual program of how each teacher is progressing through the course, that is available. So at the end of the course, if you want to take a look at, you know, how the teachers from your college have performed, that can be shared with you. I cannot hear you, sir.
Performance monitoring during the online course duration. Submission of the assignment, because we will not be accessible to that. Whether the teacher has submitted, whether they have performed well, so that we can take a corrective step.
So every participant will have access to how they're progressing in the course at any time. So there is a, in the IITBX interface, the participant can log in and see her or his progress and how many assignments they've uploaded, how, what grades they've got till then.
Thank you.
Yeah, next. 1059.
One 1059, please go ahead.
Hello.
Hello.
Audible. Hello. Good morning.
Yes, please go ahead.
Can you hear me? One question. Necessary that participants should register through the remote center. As you said, this is a MOOC, so anyone can register online.
Yeah.
Yes, anyone can register online. Anyone can register online. If, as a remote center, since you are a college, if there are many people registered from your college, as a remote center, you can also have them independently meet together once a week so that they can discuss their questions and assignments in the course.
But that's really up to you, and you can manage it in any way you want. From our perspective, it's an online course where every individual registers.
Sorry, we could not get that question.
I have to keep a watch. How many have been registered? See, in my college, say there are 80 teachers, out of which say 10 teachers are participating. Okay. Or they are registering for this course.
Okay.
If they register directly online, then I won't be able to know how many of them have registered.
So if you want to know, I
if
think
they registered through the I will be able to keep a track.
Yeah, so I think it's best if you contact the teachers directly and ask who have registered and create groups.
So we can make the list.
I don't think, no.
What we can suggest is have a coordinating teacher who will monitor all
this. Okay. Will it be possible
so,
for
yeah,
you
so this
to?
This is a valid question. And
these institutes, these many have registered. Hello.
So, yeah. So, we are just trying to ask our administrative team whether there is a mechanism to let the college know how many people from that college have registered.
Yes, actually, what we can do is like, so as soon as the teacher does the registration, somebody has to upload the list.
Okay, instead of my answering, let me give the mic to the administrative team itself. So, Mahindra from the administrative team will take care of it, yeah.
Yeah, so sir, according to your query, so what you can do is later on, sir, as soon as the teacher does the registration online in IIT Bombay's website, sir, we have a separate interface in bmwinfo.iitbombay.in. So wherein somebody has to upload the teacher's email ID and username. Later on, whatever they do in IIT Bombay X, you will be able to see the information from the BMW Info website. Is that answer your question, sir?
I have few questions, ma'am. The first thing is, being an RCC, I just wanted to know, will there be any need of AV infrastructure during the course time? And the second question is, as the previous sir asked, is there any way to know how many faculties have registered? Because I know that there are few faculties who have already registered for this course. So we would like to know how many, you can ask the other faculty members also to join this course. And the next question is, what is the last date of registration? And finally, is there any part of the content of this course which can be integrated to our LMS, learning management system?
It's not possible to integrate because the IIT Bombay X platform is different than your college LMS, which may be Moodle or something. In terms of whether you as a coordinator can come to know who else has registered, this is possible, and it's possible after some time, and we will send you information about how to do it later.
Next.
Ma'am.
Center 1088.
Hello.
Yeah.
I'm calling from KKW College of Engineering, Nasik. Thank you, madam, for this initiative. This will be very useful for the junior faculty, especially those who are not trained in the educational technology. My question is that we are going for accreditation. This is actually for the second time we are going for the accreditation, and this is outcome-based assessment now. So will your course cover some aspects of accreditation, and whether it will be useful for the teachers so that they can prepare for the accreditation visit?
Okay. So directly, we haven't taken any criteria from the accreditation, and that's not the primary goal of the course. However, a lot of topics that we will discuss in the course, especially in module 1, week 1, learning objectives, how to set the objectives, how to set course level objectives and then write topic level objectives from it, how do you design assessment questions that are aligned to objectives, all these definitely are there in different accreditation criteria, and I believe your teachers will find it useful.
Okay, we will
the
just...
The question is...
Please go ahead.
Please go ahead.
So, I was about to say that we will just do a few more since 11:30 is our cutoff time when we have to vacate the studio. So, we will just go around to centers who have not yet had a chance. But please complete your question, sir, before that.
Yeah, I understand that this is a evidence-based, research-based techniques which will be taught to us. Will we have details of those research and reference to that?
So we will put those references in what we call as learning extension resources or advancing. So there is a, when you open the interface, you will see sections called learning extension or advancing your learning. So under it, we will put links to it. Center 1146.
Good morning, sir. I have two questions. One is, as like a technical communication workshop, whether we have to work in both MOOC platform as well as IIT Bombay X or only IIT Bombay X? Okay.
This is only the IIT Bombay X platform. You don't have to go back to Moodle for this. It's only IIT Bombay X.
Okay, the second one is for peer feedback, whether we can get a feedback only from the person, those who are registered for this course, or anyone, those who are already having the login in IIT Bombay X.
So the feedback will be only from participants of this course, and there is a formal mechanism. The informal feedback you can get from anybody, any colleagues whom you are talking to, but the formal feedback will be only from other participants of this course. So we will have a mechanism through which we will enable one participant to give feedback to other participants.
Center 1148.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, madam. Type from Ghaziabad. My question is, we have time constraint, like 40 hours for each subject like that, and our classroom size is between 60 to 70. How to engage them? Our engagement is constrained, but are we thinking of engaging the students effectively beyond classrooms and all, and such a larger group, how to do effective interaction?
Yeah, so that is exactly the point of the course. So your teachers, when they go through this MOOC, that is exactly one of the things that they will learn is techniques called peer instruction, techniques called think, pair, share, and techniques of how to do assignments in Wiki. through which they will be able to engage the students not only in the classroom but also outside the classroom. So these are techniques which have been tested very well, and we use them also at IIT Bombay. Many of our instructors use them at IIT Bombay with you know, a good amount of success. So once your teachers undergo this course and they are able to create these activities of peer instruction and think pair share for their own classroom, they will be able to engage large classes for long lectures like 1 hour, 1.5 hours, because we will be breaking up the lecture into a 20-minute lecture followed by a 15-minute activity and so on and so forth. 1316. Center 1316, please.
Sir, I've got two suggestions. The first is what other people have already asked, that there should be some mechanism wherein the number of faculty members registering from our center should be known to the RCC. And another I would like to add to it is that there should be another mechanism wherein we should be able to see or view the status of the assignments being submitted by the faculty members, so that if required, we can monitor that also. We had the same mechanism in the technical communication workshops where you had been sending us the detail of the assignments being submitted by the faculty members. These are the two suggestions that I need to make.
Yeah, both of these things will become available as the course progresses. So right now, on the details will be sent by the administrative team
via email.
Center 1080.
The majority of the faculty in the engineering profession would not have had any pre-formal training of teaching or the pedagogy. So majority of them learn swimming after getting into the pool. Do you expect that courses of this nature, one of the days they'll become a prerequisite for entry or for sort of, you know, ascending in the career?
So we are kind of hoping that they will become prerequisites, because you do need training. And I think engineering profession, especially at the higher education level, is the one place where you can, you know, be a student yesterday and start becoming a teacher tomorrow without any formal training in pedagogy. So what we are trying to do is, you know, fill that gap by at least doing post induction training for the teachers.
Yeah. And I'll just add one more comment to this. It's just a comment that as some one of the other principals had mentioned, this course will be really useful to new teachers, young faculty who have joined recently, who are thrown into the pool, as you have said. So the techniques and the strategies should really give them more confidence and tools that they can use in their own class. But in addition, senior and experienced faculty have also, who've now started using these techniques, have found knowledge and application of these techniques to be useful. So we've seen from our own past experiences that faculty members across a range of their careers have benefited from similar courses and similar knowledge. So please do encourage everybody in your college to attend. Yeah, 1063.
We already discussed once, but now I would like to know whether the assignments have to be implemented and then peer assessed. Because if we have to implement, then I think people from IIT or IIT expert wouldn't be able to assess us. And finally, what would be the basic criteria for certification?
Okay. So there are various types of assignments. Some are really short and the system itself will assess them. They are about, you know, some knowledge, recall level problems, questions and so on. There are some more where you may have to create assignments, create questions for your students, and there may be yet others where you may have to implement them in class, or at least it's beneficial and desirable if you do implement them. So in terms of the feedback, what we hope will happen is that the peers, your peers, colleagues in your own institutions who are aware of the context, who know what your students are like, they will look at the quality. So that's one criteria we have. But in order to help people to give feedback, what we have are rubrics. And these have very clear descriptive criteria of what should be present in your assignment, along what dimensions it should be assessed and so on. So a combination of the rubrics and feedback from your peers is what we will be using in this course.
Oh, last interview.
Okay, let's make this the last question. Center 1146.
Hello. Good morning, ma'am. Good morning, ma'am. Happy New Year to all. So I am from Knowledge Institute of Technology. An objection towards this to you, ma'am. So why can't we suggest any competition like a conference, international conference you can conduct based on this teaching learning methodology? Yeah. Because last year you had this, you have conducted a conference. And the same thing for the second program, this is the second program you're conducting. So why can't you conduct this anything you have planned, ma'am? So that every staff members will put more effort towards this, they'll show more interest. That's my suggestion.
Okay, so let me just respond quickly to that.
Repeat the question.
The question is, can we have conferences which are encouraging such teachers to, you know, come and share their practices? So there are three conferences which are upcoming at IIT Bombay. One is in end of March, April. This is for computing education. So teachers who are in computer science and related disciplines, they will benefit by this conference. If you go to our website, we will also post links in the IIT Bombay X forum as part of the course about this conference. Another conference which we have been running for the past about 5 years is called Technology for Education, T, the number 4E. So if you just Google for T4E, you will go to the website of this conference. And this conference is also being held at IIT Bombay. So what we would invite is all your teachers to definitely come and attend this conference. And the ones who have actually implemented strategies and carried out studies using that strategies would also be very much welcome to submit papers to this conference.
Yeah.
Okay. I think that's about it.
Okay, there was one question on chat about, you know, how can we measure students' engagement or maybe students' learning and so on, and is that part of the course? So strictly speaking, this is slightly out of the scope of this particular course, even though we run other workshops on this. However, what we can do in this workshop, in this MOOC, is post links and reading material and maybe some other resources. For example, if you want to conduct a small study in your own class and submit a paper for the conferences that we just mentioned, how do you go about doing it? So we will post some links and additional material under the learning extension resources.
Okay, so thank you for being with us on Saturday morning. Once again, Happy New Year to everybody.
Yeah.
And we hope that large number of teachers from your colleges do attend this MOOC, and hopefully we will all benefit from the interactions. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.